Hello guys, in this slide we'll discuss safety device and detection of fault in current. Safety device and electrical fault. First period. At the end of this period, you should be able to define safety device, mention safety device and their uses, define accident, state safety rules and precaution in the workshop. Now, before we even talk about safety device, what is safety? Safety is freedom from harm or danger, state of being safe, state of not being dangerous or harm or harmful, a place that is free from harm or danger, a safety place. Safety is also a state of being protected from potential harm or something that has been designed to protect and prevent harm. This is what he's talking about, is how to safeguard someone, safeguard yourself from being hurt, being harmed, or from danger, and that is safety. Now, in order to save yourself from danger or harmful substance, you need to use some instruments, some materials, some devices in order to guide yourself from all these harmful or danger. Now, safety device is a piece of equipment such as fire extinguisher, safety belt, burglar alarm that reduces loss or damage from a fire, accident, or breaking. Okay, if you are not talking about this, what is that thing that always causes harmful, that is harmful to human life, or what is that thing that always hurts us, maybe when we are in the workshop or in our working place? And the major thing that always causes harmful is the accident. That is events that occur unexpectedly, you understand? And accidents are unfortunate incidents that happens unexpectedly and unintentionally, typically resulting in damage or injury. And that is accident. In order to protect ourselves from accident or some other act that may be harmful or cause injury to us, so we need to protect ourselves using what? Using safety device. We need to always be in the state of safety by using what? Safety device. Examples of safety devices and their uses. One is our safety shoe or safety boot. If you notice very well, we have different type of shoes or boots. When you are going for outing, there is a certain type of shoes for that, and when you are going to your working place, there's another type of shoe for that one. The type of shoes we use when we are in the workshop is quite different from the one we use when we are going for normal outing or when we are just playing around, you understand? This is because we are working with heavy metals, harmful materials in the workshop, so we need to wear a very hard shoe that can protect our leg, our toes, from unexpected incidents in the workshop. And that's the reason why it is very important to wear safety shoe or boot in order to protect our leg, protect our feet against bone, cuts, puncture, and impact in the workshop. Another safety device that we have is hearing protection. Most especially those people that only works in the noisy area, maybe they work with every machine that make noise, so we always use hearing protection to order in order to protect our hair from being exposed to a very noisy or loud sound that can damage our hearing. So another one that we have is eye protection. Eye protection is majorly used to protect our eye from being damaged, especially those people that work with rays of light.
that is very, very high in wavelength or intensity. So we always use goggle to protect our eye from the damage. And that is that concerning or protecting our eye from sharp objects, especially those people that work with in the wood workshop. So anytime they are cutting wood, in order for small piece of wood not to enter their eye, so they always use eye protection to protect their eye. Another one we have is lung protection. Lung protection is just to protect our breathing. Anytime we are working with chemicals, we always use maybe nose mask, the one that is designed for people working in a chemical shop, in order to protect our breathing, our lungs. And protection, we always wear glove in the workshop just to protect our eye from cuts or to want to protect our hands when we are working in the workshop. We always use hand protection like glove to protect our hand. Then we have head protection. Wearing of helmets offer protection and can prevent head injury. We always wear all those heavy helmets that is very hard to protect our head from head injury. Body protection, we always wear apron. Some wear apron, some wear just one gown in order to protect our body from maybe like fire or chemical like acid in the lab. Anytime we are working, in order to protect our body. Now, yes, though we have been protecting ourselves using safety device, and aside from that, we still need to follow some rules and regulations in the workshop in order to prevent accidents. In order to prevent accidents, because prevention is better than cure, as we all know. First one there is only those authorized to do so by workshop supervisor may work in this shop. What that one means is that if you are not competent to use the workshop, don't use the workshop. The workshop is meant for the specialist, those people that are specialized to work in certain workshop, those people who are designed, who have the ability to operate the machines, are those who are supposed to be working with the machines in the workshop. It is very dangerous for people that are not trained to be working in the workshop. That's the first one. The second one is that you may not use any power tools until you have been trained in safe operation techniques by workshop supervisor. And that one is related to the first one. Unless you have the knowledge of any machine, don't operate any machine. Don't use it unless you have the knowledge of it. Disconnect power before, that's the number three now. You disconnect power before making adjustments to power tools. Do not service energized equipment. That one is just talking about when you are not using any machine, disconnect it. Or when you detect any fault in any machine and maybe you want to do little adjustment to it, first disconnect it from power source so as to avoid unforeseen damage to your power spark. Number four, now take appropriate steps to prevent release of dust or noxious foam. Yes, make sure your workshop is always clean, free from dust, as well as for take appropriate fire prevention precautions when your work generates heat or spark or involves open flames or flammable liquid. And that's the reason why we should always have fire extinguisher in our workshop in case of fire or spark, as well as so forth. Number six, dear, do not remove machine guides. Do not you remove your machine guides. All those things that we always use to guide our machine, make sure they are always there. Anytime, each time we are using it. Then number seven, keep shop clean and tidy. You know, it is very, very important. all those maybe liquid that can cause slip in the workshop, or all those things that can cause little damage in the workshop, make sure they are not in the workshop. Always make sure that your workshop is always clean, and it is very, very important. And that is the end of the first period. I believe at the end of this period, you should be able to answer the evaluation question under it by define your safety, what is accident, mention 5 safety device and their uses. Then number 4, state 5 safety rules and precaution in the workshop. Now let's move to second period. At the end of this second period, you should be able to define electrical fault, mention the types of electrical fault, mention protection device against electrical fault, and state the causes of electrical fault and effects of electrical fault. Now, detection of faults in current. What is electrical fault? From the word fault, we know that when something is malfunctioning, we call it faulty. When something is not behaving the way it's supposed to be behaving, then the thing is faulty. Now, what is electrical fault? An electrical fault is an abnormal condition caused by equipment failure, such as transformer, rotating machine, human error, environmental condition. All those abnormal behavior in electrical machine is known as electrical fault, and all these things can lead to death of human, birds, and other animal, as well as so forth. It can cause various damage. It can even cause loss of property. When it causes spark and there is fire everywhere, then it burn a lot of things. Now, types of electrical fault, we have open circuit. That's when there is cut, when there is no continuation of current. You know, maybe a particular wire cut. We have short circuit, maybe when two wire bridge each other. We have symmetrical and unsymmetrical. Maybe when there is cutting wire and it touches the ground, touches the head, and so on and so forth. Protection device against fault. We have different materials on which we use to protect our devices, our electronics, our machines against electrical faults. The first one is fuse. Fuse, it opens. Fuse is just that device that opens or cuts when there is excess flow of current. It opens the circuit whenever a fault exists in the system. If there is excess flow of current, it just cuts. That fuse is always in a tiny globe, with middle of tiny wire like this. When there is excess current flowing through the wire, there's going to be cut, and that is a fuse. We have circuit breaker. This is the most common protection device that can make or break the circuit, either manually or through remote control under normal operating system, under normal operating condition. That is circuit breaker. We have protective relay. This device detects fault and initiates the operation of the circuit breaker. Initiate operation of circuit breaker so as to isolate the faulty circuit. We have lightning arrestor. Lightning arrestor is what we always use to arrest lightning. You know, lightning is just like discharge of electron in the cloud when there is a thunderstorm. We have discharge of excess electron from the cloud, in order not to affect our own electrical materials, we always use lightning arrestor. It's just like a surge in the power system network caused when there is lightning strike on the transmission line and equipment. This causes high voltage and current in the system. These lightning faults are reduced by placing lightning arrestor at the transmission equipment. It just helps to arrest those excess discharge of electron so as not to affect our electrical materials. Causes of electrical faults. We have different causes of electrical faults. Something that causes fault in our electrical material. One, weather condition. Maybe when it's about to rain, you know, there's going to be a heavy wind and this one can break most of the materials that is taking current, that is carrying current from one place to another. That is why in most cases, if there is going to be heavy rain, or NEPA will always switch off the light so as not to cause some damages to most of our electrical materials. Another one is equipment failure. Maybe one of the equipment we are using, all those materials that made up of these electrical materials, one of them is expired, or one of them is no more working properly. So it's going to cause another fault into some others. We have number three to be human error. Human error. We are born to make mistakes. So if there is a little mistake, you know, in the connection of electrical system, there's going to be spark, or it's going to cause a lot of damages to other components of the electrical system. Then we have smokes or fire. Smokes or fire. If there is excess heat, maybe the electrical material is generating excess heat, it's going to cause fire. And when there is fire like that, then it's going to cause a fault to the electrical materials. Then effect, it causes over current flow, that is excess flow of current. Then another one is, it is danger to operating personnel, you know, it can take life. Then it causes loss of equipment to disturb interconnected active circuits, and it causes electrical fire, you know, when there is excess flow of current. Then this is your assignment. At the end of the lesson, you are expected to solve these three assignments. State the effect of electrical faults. What is electrical faults? Explain any three protection devices against electrical faults. Mention the types of electrical faults. What is lightning arrest? When we meet online, we'll discuss more about it. Thank you.